It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to proclaim His wonders among the people. Dear parents, teachers, students, alumni, and well-wishers of SJC family, today, 27th August 2021, St. Joseph's Convent, Chandannagar completes 160 years of noble service, of igniting the light of knowledge and ministering to the physical, cultural, social, and moral needs of tens of thousands of students who today are our joy and our pride. We feel a deep sense of thankfulness to God Almighty, who has been our shelter and guide, our hope and courage, by pouring out His blessings abundantly from His bountiful hand on all our undertakings for the past 160 years. DEO GRATIAS, thanks be to God. We remain indebted to our pioneer sisters who were inspired and strengthened by the love of Christ, spearheaded the work of our congregation in North India. In the sweltering heat of an August afternoon, a small band of three French sisters from Pondicherry, after a few hours of tossing on the Hooghly River, reached Chandannagar on boat from Howrah. They were happy to come to Chandannagar to mother the poor and the suffering. Soon they forgot their seasicknesses, weariness and loneliness. No electricity, no pipe water. They carried water from the Hooghly River and subjected to several purification before being used. Under the guidance of Mother Merici, St. Joseph's Convent was put in order. Classrooms were prepared, a dispensary and a creche equipped, and 8 orphans were taken in. The pioneers courageously overcame difficulties, and their persevering labor yielded a magnificent harvest. 2 higher secondary schools, a dispensary, and a school for the marginalized. Our hearts overwhelm with gratitude to all our sisters who sacrificed their lives and went about doing good to all. We are grateful to all our stakeholders of the past and present. Teachers for their sincere dedication and commitment. Parents for their trust and cooperation. Students for their heartfelt love and loyalty. Support staff for ensuring safe learning environment. Managing committee members for their professional advice, and well-wishers and benefactors for their timely assistance. My special thanks goes to the staff and students who, in spite of this pandemic, worked tirelessly to make this celebration a meaningful and a memorable one, giving a glimpse of SJC to all who could not be a part of it. As we celebrate the completion of 160 years, we are confident that God who began this good work will carry on in the years to come. May He help us to accomplish His holy will, like our mother foundress, Blessed Anne Marie Jauvet, who said, "Nothing is lost that is done for God." May SJC grow from strength to strength under the protection of Saint Joseph. I wish you all a very happy 160th anniversary of the school. Thank you.
center of 22.87 degree north latitude and 88.37 degree east longitude lies the prestigious educational institution, Saint Joseph's Convent. Standing sublime on the banks of River Hooghly since 1861. The biblical extract, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains alone, may aptly be applied to Saint Joseph's Convent, which was but an insignificant grain at its inception, and now is a premier institution with worldwide branches.
Though small in extent, Chandannagar is articulate in its tradition. It is a separate, self-fulfilling chapter in the history of alien rule in India. It can be taken for certain from the information about this place in ancient texts that the city named Chandannagar grew up during the French regime, covering mainly three villages of Boro Kishanpur, Kholishani and Godolpara. In 1757, the French were defeated by the British, but the church and Nandadulal temple survived the shelling of the British. The chapel of St. Joseph's Convent still has the historic door of 1720 fixed to it.
Tucked away in the suburbs, about 32 kilometers away from Kolkata, in the erstwhile French town of Chandannagar, nestles St. Joseph's Convent. A few feet away, the mighty Hooghly flows. Now up, now down, now lashing against its banks as it charges up from the sea. Or again, lies calm and still, like a sleeping baby in its cot.
No account of the history of Chandannagar will be complete without a reference to the pioneering work of this convent in women's education. In 1861, the Order of the Sisters of St. Joseph of Cluny founded SJC at Chandannagar. 160 years is an age that not many institutions can talk about. This school has been imparting education for a period that spans across generations. Children who have walked in, holding the hands of their parents, left the school confident to take their roles in society. It has shaped the future of thousands of children. As we celebrate this day, we remember the affection that we have received as teachers, as parents,
and of course, as students. The missionary spirit of our founders, Blessed Anne Marie Jarve, whom Napoleon aptly called a great man, brought the three sisters from Puducherry to the shores of River Hooghly on the 27th of August 1861. The seeds sown by those pioneer sisters have grown into a mighty tree, touching and transforming the lives of many. The wonderful dream of our beloved foundress, Mother Jarve, is being carried forward by the Cluny sisters, staff and students of SJC. The Cluny family in Chandannagar is imbibed with an indomitable spirit to fill the atmosphere of this esteemed institution with the never-changing life principles of happiness and goodness, simplicity and kindness.
Today, marks an important event in the history of SJC as it completes 160 glorious years of its establishment. The contribution of St. Joseph's Convent to society, be it the teaching of moral values, health services, social services, or preservation of Indian culture, is immeasurable. We are proud to be a part of this revered institution. We thank God for every new day.
Here in SJC, our motto is pray and work. It is a driving force which ensures complete devotion and glory to God, the source of all creative energy. The will to actively work and make a contribution while walking hand in hand with God is derived from this magical motto. Our school, St. Joseph's Convent, is marching an extra mile with a smile as it accomplishes the momentous task of molding lives and minds. It indeed is a great achievement in itself. Established in the year 1861, SJC has certainly gone a long way.
The great family of Josephites rejoice as they look back with gratitude to God for the rich life and legacy bequeathed by the founding pioneers. They have indeed left behind a legacy of unshakable faith in God's love and providence. Let us keep the flame of Blessed Anne Marie burning brightly and pass on her legacy to the coming generations in all its purity and integrity.
The spirit of Blessed Anne Marie lives on. From day to day, year to year, the ministering sisters strive to bring joy where there is sorrow, light of education to the unenlightened, comfort to the agonized, and solace to the lamenting.
She lives because her daughters from every race, nation, and tongue have but one heart and one soul. They continue in the church the work the Lord has entrusted to them. She lives on.
As we celebrate the completion of 160 years, our hearts overflow with gratitude to God and to those heroic pioneer sisters who went bravely forward into the unknown. Deo gratias. May God, who was their guide, enable us, who are the beneficiaries of this rich heritage, to follow Him trustfully in the years to come. We thank the Lord for the glorious past. We thank the Lord for the present steadfast. We thank the Lord for the promising future. Deo gratias. For the glorious past, as we rejoice for all that has been, as we move towards a hopeful, a better, a brighter tomorrow, keeping aflame the mission and vision of Mother Jave. We move towards a better tomorrow that will bring new hope, new life to the world around us. May God be praised forever. Deo gratias.
We would like to express our gratitude to all our superiors, principals, and all the sisters who have encouraged every one of us here at SJC. We would also like to extend our gratitude to our dear parents who have supported us in good times and bad times. This school has enriched all of us at every moment of our lives. The wonder that our school is remains firm in our hearts and etched in our memories. I thank the Almighty for His abundant blessings on the school and on us. As we begin the prayer service, I request our Provincial Superior, Sister Anselm, to light the ceremonial lamp and mark the beginning of this celebration. I also request our Superior and Principal, Sister Anna Maria, to come up and light the lamp. I request Sister George, our former Superior and Principal, to come up and light the lamp. May I also request Sister Charlotte, our former Superior, to light the lamp. I now request our Vice Principal, Sister Gloria, to light the lamp.
Chimani penu yehovana muralalinchi
Celebrate the 160 glorious years of our beloved institution, we humbly recollect the 27th day of August 1861, when our three sisters from Pondicherry arrived on a humid, sultry afternoon to sow the seeds of love, peace, joy, knowledge, compassion, goodness, and mercy in the soil of Chandannagar on the banks of River Hooghly. We thank God for those sisters who sacrificed their lives for Jesus, following the footsteps of Blessed Aunt Marie Jave, our foundress, and helped these seeds to take root in the hearts of thousands of young children. Their love and compassion stretched out to all, the poor, the sick, the orphans, the needy, and the neglected. We remember with gratitude all the sisters, teachers, students, parents, support staff, benefactors, well-wishers, and friends who gave their time, talents, skills, and energy in the past to help this institution to grow into a fruitful, life-giving tree. We thank you, Lord, for guiding them to walk on the path of truth and righteousness, so that we can enjoy the fruits of their hard labor. Grant eternal rest to all those whom you have called. Grant happy and peaceful times to those who were a part of this institution. And bless all those who continue to serve you in and through this institution. Amen.
Heavenly Father, on this day, as our school completes its 160 years, we thank you for guiding us in each and every step we have taken in the past, are taking in the present, and will be taking in the future. We thank you for creating this beautiful garden called SJC. You have blessed it, nourished it, protected it, and let the flowers, your children, grow and spread the essence of purity, love, and compassion. You bless us with divine teaching and learning through our sisters and teachers, the gardeners who with their wisdom and hard work help us, the blooming buds, to bloom into tender flowers. We thank you for this abode of wisdom and knowledge where we grow into sharing, caring, and respectable ladies of the future society. Bless us, dear Father, and protect us from all harm and evil. Amen.
Dear Lord, we come to praise and thank you for the past 160 years of untiring service that our school has selflessly been rendering to our society, to our nation, and to the world at large. We, the weak seeds that were sown in this institution, were changed into beautiful plants and flowers during our stay in this institution and have now become fruit-bearing trees. Moral values, spiritual development, character formation, academic excellence, co-curricular activities have all helped us to be what we are today. On behalf of all the students who passed out of this institution, we thank you, Lord, for all the marvels and wonders you have done for our alma mater and will continue to do, for all the success the school has achieved and will always achieve, and for making us what we are today and what our future generation will be. May the love of the Father, the tenderness of the Son, and the presence of the Spirit protect our school today and forever. Amen.
Guest who is working relentlessly
in the social and educational front in Chandannagar for the past 160 years. Amazed, right? Please be glued to your seats and to your screen. Here she is, 160 years old, yet young in spirit. Evergreen, our very own St. Joseph's Convent, Chandannagar. Keep in continuance with your reminiscences, we also have with us one of the sisters of St. Joseph of Cluny, who is working in this community for more than 50 years now. Welcome, Sister Michelle.
To add anecdotes, we have with us a teacher from SJC, who's been teaching for 20 years now. She has been a student of this prestigious institution as well. Viewers, please welcome Mrs. Shrabani Guha. Please put your hands together for all the three guests with us.
Today is a very special day since it marks the completion of the 160th year of SJC. If you could be kind enough to share with us how it all began. Do you remember?
Yes, very vividly. In 1680, the first Catholic church here in Chandannagar was built by Father Tashad, a French priest. Much later, around 1860, the parish priest of Chandannagar, Father Bathe, impressed by the work done by the sisters in Pondicherry, requested the government to bring the sisters here in Chandannagar to open schools. And above all, to help the orphans that successive famines had left in their wake. It was not a pleasure trip for the sisters at all. It took them around 6 days of travel. But soon, all difficulties were forgotten, and the parish priest welcomed the three sisters of St. Joseph of Cluny.
Asha Shalaboy, welcome to Chandannagar. We have been eagerly awaiting your arrival. May God give you strength to accomplish the difficult tasks here. May you be made strong with all the strength that comes from His glorious power, so that you are able to endure everything with patience.
Yes, Father, work must begin immediately.
He is there with us. He will not fail us.
We are so thankful to the French government for having placed the trust in us and letting us work for the betterment of the society.
I have heard that the Sisters of St. Joseph of Cluny had initially put up in the old chapel, the parish church in Chandannagar, right?
No, their first lodging was in a small house adjacent to the parish church. Thus, with 8 orphans in the house, St. Joseph's Convent was formally set up in 1861.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we move on to further talks, let me tell you that the chapel of St. Joseph's Convent, Chandannagar, dates back to 1720, built by Capuchin friars. It stands as a mute witness to the changing history of times. Sister, today is a very special day, since it marks the completion of the 160th year of SJC. If you could be kind enough to share with us some memorable incidents.
Oh, plenty comes to my mind. Initially, when the sisters came here, it was an arduous task. The sisters would be running all the time with medicines and nourishing food for the starving children. On top of that, getting the children to school was a challenge.
Please listen to me. Children must learn to study and play. You, as parents, do you want them to suffer the way you are when they grow up? Bring them to us. Let them get education. As long as the sisters are here,
We'll give them the noon meal and the evening tea. They'll learn sewing, stitching. We'll teach them to read and write. So when they grow up, they can make a living for themselves.
Poor child! He seems to have malaria!
Unfortunate
child!
Yeah.
Have been very enterprising throughout. Their dedication and service round the clock had the school growing up. Initially, the sisters would go to the Chandannagar hospital to tend to the sick. Then, in 1957, they came up with their own dispensary and responsibility increased manifold. More buildings started coming up throughout the campus. I experienced joys, I saw pains within my arms, the homeless and the sick during the famine. I had my happy moments too, watching the girls hobbling about the place, brimming with life and energy. Sisters in impeccable white, moving around, tending to each student.
For the contributions of these sisters. Their extended helping hands, many French and Irish sisters, they sacrificed their lives for the betterment of the people here. Also, how can we forget Sister McTild, who started the St. Anthony School in 1953? Also, the St. Mary's Social Service Centre for the Poor, set up in 1967, besides providing education, provides food and clothing too.
Interesting facts. I have heard that till 1980s, there were only two houses, the Marians and the Immaculates, not the four houses as we have now. There must have been high competitive spirits running between Sister Declan, the moderator of the Marian House, and Sister Norbert, the moderator of the Immaculates.
Those were such days, such enthusiasm.
Now, I wish to know more about your motto, pray and work.
In the words of our foundress, Mother Anne-Marie Jave, pray, pray. The good God grants all to humble prayers. No work has meaning unless you pray for it to be successfully over.
Yes, no prayer holds good unless you work and act. I'm really proud that we have been able to instill this in the girls.
Even today, you're held in high esteem
for your ideals on discipline, charity and integrity.
I am proud that we have been able to inculcate in our girls the values of faith, truthfulness, perseverance and selfless service.
Absolutely. And that is what makes St. Joseph's Convent, Chandannagar, a legacy.
Mrs. Guha, my next question is for you. How was SJC when you were a student? If you could share some memorable anecdotes.
As a student, I've received so much from the school that I grew up determined to be a teacher so that I could nurture young minds like my sisters and my teachers did. I remember some of my neighbors used to jeer at my parents that being in an English medium school, I would never learn my mother tongue properly, nor the culture of my motherland.
Thankfully, here we sisters and teachers have imbibed Indian culture and traditions among the girls.
My walls have been echoing with Hindi, Bengali recitations, Tagore songs.
চাটা যা বানিয়েছো না আজ কি হলো গিন্নি কি এত ভাবছো
ভাবছি মেয়েটার কথা একটা ভালো স্কুলে ভর্তি না করা পর্যন্ত শান্তি পাচ্ছি না
ভেবে দেখো কি চাও বেস্ট স্কুল নাকি বেস্ট এডুকেশন মেয়েটা যেভাবে দাদুর কাছে রূপকথার গল্প শুনতে ভালোবাসে
কিন্তু ইংরাজিটাও তো সমানভাবে শেখা দরকার এই যুগে
ঠিকই কিন্তু এমন কোন স্কুল আছে যেখানে ইংরেজিটাও শিখবে আবার বাংলার প্রতি ভালোবাসাটাও বজায় থাকবে
আচ্ছা তোমার সুমির কথা মনে আছে আমার বন্ধু দাঁড়াও বরং ওকে একটা ফোন করি ও আমাকে এই ব্যাপারে সঠিক পরামর্শ দিতে পারবে ফোনটা স্পিকারে দিচ্ছি তুমিও শোনো ও কি বলে
হ্যালো অনেক দিন পর কি খবর বল
এই যে ডাক্তার সুমিলিতা সান্যাল তোর কাছে একটা পরামর্শ চাই তোর সময় আছে কথা বলার
আরে হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ বল না
মেয়েটার জন্য একটা ভালো স্কুল সাজেস্ট কর না
ও এই কথা
কেন সেন্ট জোসেফস কনভেন্ট চন্দননগর
দ্য বেস্ট আমি ওই স্কুলে পড়ে আজ প্রতিষ্ঠিত ডাক্তার
কিন্তু ওই স্কুলে পড়ানোর জন্য এত জোর দিচ্ছ কেন
আসলে সেন্ট জোসেফস কনভেন্টের সাথে একটা খুব সুন্দর ইতিহাস জড়িয়ে আছে মাদার আনমারি জাভে দ্য ফার্স্ট উমেন মিশনারি আফ্রিকা দক্ষিণ আমেরিকা ওয়েস্ট ইন্ডিজ এমনকি ভারতবর্ষেও তিনি কনভেন্ট স্থাপন করেছিলেন 70 বছর বয়স পর্যন্ত তিনি অনাথ শিশু আর ক্রীতদাসদের যেভাবে আগলে রেখেছিলেন তার এই কর্মদক্ষতা দেখে নেপোলিয়ন বোনাপার্টে তাকে গ্রেট ম্যান আখ্যা দিয়েছিলেন তারই আদর্শে অনুপ্রাণিত
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ শুনেছি তিনজন সিস্টার এসেছিলেন এই স্কুল প্রতিষ্ঠার জন্য
সেই সময় তো চন্দননগরে দাস প্রথাও ছিল জীবন যথেষ্ট কঠিন ছিল
হ্যাঁ মাদার মেরিচে সিস্টার মেকটিলুই সিস্টার ইগনেস ফেইসে 1861 সালের 27 অগস্টে এখানে এলেন তারা বুঝিয়েছিলেন শিক্ষা আনে চেতনা চেতনা আনে মুক্তি তাই মাত্র 8 জন অনাথ মেয়েকে নিয়ে শুরু হলো এসজেসির পথ চলা
শুনেছি নাকি ওখানে একটা অনেক পুরনো চ্যাপেলও রয়েছে
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ ঠিক বলেছ ওটা তো 300 বছর পুরনো চন্দননগরের সব ভালো মন্দের সাক্ষী ধৈর্য ও শান্তির প্রতীক হয়ে সেই কবে থেকে স্কুলের মাঝে দাঁড়িয়ে আছে
বাহ সত্যি এই ইতিহাসের এক অংশ হতে পারাটাও বেশ গর্বের ব্যাপার
অনেক ধন্যবাদ সুমি আমাদের সঠিক পথ দেখানোর জন্য আচ্ছা রে এবার রাখি তুই ভালো থাকিস
হ্যালো নন্দিতা কিরে বল
হ্যালো সুমি তোর কথাই ভাবছিলাম তোর পরামর্শেই সেন্ট জোসেফস কনভেন্টে ভর্তি করেছিলাম আজ তার ক্লাস টেনের রেজাল্ট বেরোবে তাই তোর কথাই আজ সবার আগে মনে পড়ল
ক্লাস টেনের রেজাল্ট? ও বাবা, দেখতে দেখতে বারোটা বছর কেটে গেল। তোর মেয়ে তো বড় হয়ে গেল রে। আমি কিন্তু আমার ভাইজির থেকে খবর পাই, ও খুব ভালো কবিতা আবৃত্তি বলে, ভালো রবীন্দ্রসঙ্গীত গায়, বাংলাতে হায়েস্ট মার্কস পায়।
কী যে বলিস সুমি, আজকাল কি আর বাংলা শিখে কিছু হবে? আমার কত দিনের স্বপ্ন যিনি ইংলিশ শিখবে, এমনি এমনি কি আর কনভেন্ট স্কুলে ভর্তি করলাম?
তুই ভুল করছিস নন্দিতা, জানিস তো আমার শৈশবের বারোটা বছর জড়িয়ে আছে এসজেসির সাথে। আমার স্কুল ইংরাজির সাথে সাথে সব ভার্নাকুলার ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজেসদের সমান মর্যাদা দেয়। আমাদের সিস্টারদের ত্যাগ, সেবা, নিরলস পরিশ্রম আমাদের দেশ ও জাতিকে চিনতে শিখিয়েছে। ইংরাজি মাধ্যম স্কুল হলেও যে কোনো অনুষ্ঠানে আমরা প্রচুর হিন্দি আর বাংলা প্রোগ্রাম করেছি রে।
ঠিক আছে রে, এবার রাখছি, আবার তো স্কুলে যেতে হবে।
মা, ও মা, এই যে আমি এখানে।
রেজাল্ট বেরোলো?
কী রে, কেমন হলো? আমি স্কুলে সেকেন্ড হায়েস্ট মা, ইংলিশে আর দু নম্বর বেশি পেলেই আমি টপার হতাম।
ফার্স্ট কে হলো নামটা শুনি?
দেবলীনা।
চল বাড়িতে, দেখাচ্ছি আজ।
আহা নন্দিতা, ওকে অত বকছো কেন? রেজাল্ট তো খারাপ করেনি।
কিন্তু মা, আমি যে বাংলায় হায়েস্ট পেয়েছি স্কুলে।
বাংলায় পেয়ে কি হবে, ইংলিশে ফার্স্ট হলে বুঝতাম।
কিন্তু মা, আমি বাঙালি, বাংলা আমার মাতৃভাষা।
খুব বড় হয়ে গেছিস না, আবার মুখে মুখে কথা বলতে শিখেছিস।
মা, কেন তুমি আমার উপর এত রাগ করছো? স্কুলে যখন রবীন্দ্র জয়ন্তী, বর্ষবরণের অনুষ্ঠান হয়, তখন তুমি তো আমায় বাংলা গান গাইতে কত উৎসাহিত করো। স্কুলের হয়ে যখন আমি ইন্টার স্কুল কম্পিটিশনে বাংলা কবিতা আবৃত্তি করে ফার্স্ট প্রাইজ আনি, তখন সিস্টার টিচারদের পাশাপাশি তুমিও তো কত খুশি হও মা। এক বছর কনসার্টের আগে মেসেদের শিখিয়ে দেওয়া বাংলা নাটকের সংলাপ বাড়ি এসে ভুলে গিয়েছিলাম, তখন তুমি তো মেসেদের কাছ থেকে জেনে নিয়ে আমায় শিখিয়েছিলে।
চিনি,
স্কুলেই শিখেছি মা, মাতৃভাষা ও দেশমাতার সম্মান রক্ষা করতে গিয়ে কত মানুষ প্রাণ দিয়েছেন, নিজের সংস্কৃতিকে ভুলি কি করে মা? যে ভাষায় মায়ের কোলে শুয়ে ঠোঁটে মুখে প্রথম আধো বলি, যে ভাষায় বাতাস নিচে নুয়ে মাটিতে বোলায় প্রীতির তুলি।
বাহ বাহ, দারুণ বলেছিস তো।
তুই আমার চোখ খুলে দিলি চিনি। 160 বছরের একটা ঐতিহ্যবাহী স্কুলে পড়ে সব দিক থেকে তুই একজন সম্পূর্ণ মানুষ হয়ে উঠছিস। সত্যি বলছি চিনি, আজ তোকে দেখে এত ভালো লাগছে। আজ মনে হচ্ছে এই স্কুলে ভর্তি করে আমি যা চেয়েছিলাম তার থেকে অনেক বেশি পেলাম।
তাই তো মা, আমার গর্ব সেন্ট জোসেফস কনভেন্ট, যেখানে আমরা গড়ে উঠি একজন পরিপূর্ণ নাগরিক হিসেবে। তুমি দেখবে মা, একদিন তোমার সব স্বপ্ন সফল হবে। সিস্টারদের সেবা মন্ত্রে দীক্ষিত হয়ে টিচারদের সহযোগিতায় আমরাই দাঁড়াবো মানুষের পাশে, আমরাই নিজেদের কাঁধে তুলে নেব এই বিশ্বের দায়ভার, উজ্জ্বল করব দেশমাতার মুখ, গড়ে তুলব এক সমৃদ্ধশালী স্বপ্নের দেশ।
Education is a formation of the whole person. Let us inculcate human and social values to become agents of social transformation. It is our duty to promote a world of peace and justice in which we, humans and nature, can live together in harmony. May God help us to fulfill His plans in our life as we strive together towards a better tomorrow.
Till 1980s, we had boarders. Students from faraway places used to stay here.
In the evenings after games and tea, they used to gather in the study hall for their preparations and home assignments. They would be involved in various games and activities. Even today, girls are so enthusiastic for any inter-school co-curricular activities. Another activity that the girls take up with passion and zeal is guiding. They specially enjoy the guide camp.
Yes, from Rabindra Jayanti to Hindi Divas, from Reading Day, Earth Day, from Diwali to Christmas, from All Faith Prayer Service, everything. Our girls celebrate every occasion with the same zeal.
Yes, it was really wonderful.
Good morning,
sister.
Good morning, dear children.
Did you watch the feast day program on Friday?
Sister, did you watch the class 5 dance? I was in the front row.
Thank you, children. You people were really wonderful. Also, when you painted while dancing, that was so heart-touching. Also, the English recitation, oh my God, it was wonderful.
Thank you, sister. Sister, do you know that for the upcoming inter-school fest, I have been chosen for the action song.
Sister, Miss has selected me for the folk dance.
Even I am there, sister, for the English elocution.
Very good. You must all perform very well and make HSC proud.
Of course, sister.
May God bless you all.
Thank you, sister.
Good afternoon, miss. One good news. Jaya and Rachaita, who had been to the inter-school debate, they have come first. Not only that, Jaya has been not just the best speaker. What a proud moment for us.
Oh wow! Miss, I heard that in the RBI National 11 quiz, our girls have come as finalists from the Eastern Zone.
Yes.
What a proud moment.
You're right, my child.
What a wonderful work.
Yes, that is there. But do you realize we are getting late for the Independence Day event?
Miss, that's why we came to ask you, can we practice after lunch?
Yes, certainly, my child.
Surely, Miss, Independence Day's program of SJC can be nothing lesser than the best.
Yes, that is why I am saying the Independence Day program coming up next should be a glorious one.
Tadim, tadim, nadradim, tanundradim.
Vande Mataram.
सुखदां वरदां मातरं वंदे मातरं
blessing. I enjoy watching the preparations for each occasion, meticulous planning by the teachers and sincere practice by the girls. Thanks to the sisters, teachers and the students, the effort that they put in, the extra hours, the extra pain.
That is true. You are indeed an ideal for whom they make all these sacrifices. It is your love and care that they return in plentiful.
It is all for my sisters and teachers that I stand strong and firm today. My children, the trust their parents have put in me has made me stand like the sycamore today.
160 saal pehle, Pashchim Bengal mein, Hugli ke kinare, Clooney sisters ke haathon likha gaya tha anant aksharon mein itihas.
बीज बोया एक छोटा सा मन में लेकर एक आस चंदन नगर को अपनी कर्म भूमि चुना था ईश्वर पर पूर्ण विश्वास था ईश्वर पर पूर्ण विश्वास
आन मारी जावे का नाम रोशन करने की मन में ठानी थी उनकी शिक्षा दुनिया के कोने कोने में जो पहुंचानी थी
प्रत्येक पग पर चुनौतियों का किया सामना पर हार नहीं मानी थी जो जगी थी उनके मन में वह लौ हर जगह जगानी थी अपनी मेहनत निस्वार्थ प्रेम से हर मन पर एक अमिट छाप छोड़ दी मार्ग में आने वाली हर बाधा की दिशा मोड़ दी SJC का नाम रोशन किया हर तरफ इसका सुयश फैलाया 160 वर्षों में लाखों दिलों पर अपना परचम लहराया
खिल उठी कली कली नया विकास आ गया
शिक्षा क्षेत्र में नया प्रभात आ गया मेहनत क्लूनी सिस्टर्स की रंग लाई हर तरफ SJC का नाम छा गया अनुशासन से है जीवन बनता
अनुशासन से है उपवन खिलता अनुशासन राष्ट्र का जीवन है
यह शिक्षित जन का तन मन और धन है यह प्रथम पाठ था जो आगे ने बच्चों को पढ़ाया
परमार्थ परहित
और पुरुषार्थ
शिक्षा के अभिन्न अंग और अभियानों का मूल चलना चलते रहना और ऊंचाइयों को छूना यह जीवन के बड़े उसूल
हजारों जीवन सवर गए इस शिक्षा के मंदिर में अविरल धारा के शाश्वत प्रवाह में दुनिया के हर कोने में देश की प्रगति में अपना योगदान दिया हर क्षेत्र में अपनी एक पहचान बनाई
SJC का नाम रोशन किया आन मारी जावे आपके त्याग आपकी तपस्या ने कितने जीवों को जीवन दान दिया है अपने प्रेम और सेवा से ईश्वर की रचना में आपने अनुपम योगदान दिया है
आप संत हैं, आप वंदनीय हैं,
दिल आपको शत शत प्रणाम करता है लाखों जीवन सवारे हैं आपने हर जोसेफाइट अपना जीवन आपके नाम करता है
अपना जीवन आपके नाम करता है धन्यवाद
इन
Indeed, you have for all these 160 years wonderful moments to be proud of. Modernization and upgradation, and your prime topic of pride, your ex-students. They are splashing news all over the world. Doctors, engineers, chartered accountants, film directors, hoteliers, IAS, IPS officers, businessmen, all attaining fame and glory for themselves and for their school. Moreover, their academic performances in both ICSE and ISC are really praiseworthy. And this year it was 99.75%. Truly, these girls are really diligent.
We have a surprise for you, Sister Michelle. Do you recognize the lady there?
You are Aparajita, right? Aparajita Mukherjee, 2005 batch.
My God, sister, what a memory. I can't believe that you still remember me.
Your presence was such a delight.
I remember your batch collecting donations for the tsunami victims. How you went about from door to door.
Yes, the Sundarbans people were so emotional when we sent provisions there.
I have also heard that recently for the cyclone Amphan and for the cyclone Yas, you all did a commendable job.
We, as followers of our blessed Aunt Mari Jave, always compassionately help the ones in need.
I have also heard that SJC students go for social service rounds to various places like Pravartak in Chandannagar, and there's another one, Partners in Bandel, Louis Braille Memorial School in Uttarpara,
Shushar Home in Sharampur, and the oldest home of St. Joseph in Kolkata.
This is what I am really proud of, the way the girls willingly contribute towards social service.
Not only in terms of money, but they spend time with them. They feed them, they entertain them with their dance and music, they tie rakhis and click photographs with them. Not only that, even after passing out, our girls go to their places and celebrate their birthday and share their joy with them.
Yes, it is a very overwhelming experience for each one of them.
I have also heard that each year, every class has a specific social service mission.
In fact, the students are involved in the social welfare too, especially the care of the environment.
Yes, we do have tree plantation program.
So every year on World Environment Day and Earth Day?
No, not only on those specific days. In fact, as farewell gifts to the class 12. Nowadays, the school gives potted plants as mementos. Moreover, we have Green Earth Club. Our students have taken out awareness rallies, made jute bags and distributed to people. We conduct seminars and talks, and noted environmentalists have visited our school.
The initiative to ban plastic use within the school premises is really commendable.
And it's great that you distributed jute bags to each student.
Hey Devadrita!
Shravantika, Prishti, let's climb the sapling!
Come
oh,
on!
We are so excited!
This is the sapling we are planting for Sister's Feast Day. And we must keep some space for the upcoming 160 year celebration. We need to give some saplings. Prishti and Devadrita, can you please bring the flower pots?
Oh, sure!
To give the flowers to our teachers on Teachers' Day. Please go and bring the other pots.
Sure.
We have also heard that there was a grand celebration on sesquicentenary.
It was such a cheerful and joyful occasion.
Yes, many of us ex-students came to attend it. Such grandeur.
His Excellency Jean-Louis Richetot was the chief guest.
Yes. And the evening celebration was mesmerizing. In fact, the medley of songs sung still ring in my ears. But Sister Michelle, there's one regret, which the girls of my batch will always have. The Nanette Nursery started in 1998. It wasn't there in our times.
বাজতে হবে রে রে এ আবার কি আল্লাহ এ আবার কি আল্লাহ
And we were out after ICSC. The ISE batch started from 2004. How I wish that it was there in our times. 14 long summers we would have spent here. Have passed on the tradition to the present, and I'm sure it will be continued by the future students, the Nanets.
We have put in our best to preserve the past, perfect the present, and promote the future. And for this, I am ever grateful to God Almighty.
Music loud and women warm. I've been kicked around since I
Love and care of every soul associated with SJC, for which I stand strong and firm today, unaffected by mishaps.
Yes, absolutely. They are your pillars of strength and support.
Another feather on the cap was the intercultural exchange between our students and the Japanese dancers.
Parika Motsumi, director of this program.
Valuable workshop, a wonderful opportunity for our students.
There will be many more to come, I'm sure. Your students are really lucky to have such a rainbow of activities along with academics. Here we witness another colorful glimpse of your celebrations.
Colors and promises.
edge of the water, long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water, no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls to me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know. If I go, there's just no telling how far I'll go.
For a girl like me, so they tell me that you're looking for a girl like me. Ah, you're looking for a girl like me.
Hey, I want a girl like Shakira. Hey, esa latina está rica. I want a family, a chica que sepa vivir y que viva la vida.
Just what I wanna be, what I wanna be, just what I wanna be. I don't know you, but I am blessed by the heaven. Someone's gotta hold on me, sweet, but I get rough. Just what I wanna be, what I wanna be, just what I wanna be. I don't know you, but I'm just what I wanna be.
Gonna call when you ain't got the Me and Megan run up in the spot like I pop off cause I am the reigning champ. Please no comparisons cause you know they can't. Had to cut the grass, there was snakes in the camp. They know I'm the Billy, I be laughing. Ha 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 ha. One minute I'm nice, the next I'm on top. My guest house alone cost like 3 tickets. In that Rolls truck and that paint job real wicked. Used to dumb dumb myself down for these chickens. Now when dumb dumb talk I smile and be crickets. Boom, every head when I walk in the room. Pretty in real life, hit my pics with the zoom. A 10 when they rate it like tune. Elevated to the penthouse, we ain't stopping anytime soon.
Look at me, this is the face of a champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together in loud appreciation. A big thank you to SJC and all the honored guests for being here at our chat today. We, Ujjaini Basu
and Manushi Chatterjee, winding off today. We will meet soon on the 175th year of this evergreen lady. Till then, goodbye.
DEO GRATIAS! Fasten your seatbelts, the best is yet to come. The grand closing ceremony of the completion of the 160th year of this legacy.
Thank you.
with mother's arms around the soil. The school that is a joy and pride.